Now today, I've got a question for you. Have you ever experienced a fucked up camera lens when you take your camera in a housing underwater to either film or take photos? If that has happened and you can answer this question with yes, congratulations, you are allowed to continue watching this video. If you've never experienced that situation, well, feel free to click away and check out this video, or this playlist better, where we talk about tips and tricks for filmmaking. You're still here, so that means that you did experience the problem that I have experienced many, many times in the past, especially when I started off with taking photos and filming underwater. A fogged up lens. Now, why does a lens actually fog up? I took a moment to reflect on this and I came up with what I think is the actual proper solution or proper explanation for why your underwater camera lens or the housing, the lens on the housing fogs up. Now the problem or the issue here is that you do experience in most situations a temperature change once you take your camera from out on air down into the water. Oftentimes you can make this worse by assembling your camera in a environment that is humid. So as you're actually putting your camera inside the housing, so I can open this. Very tricky, childproof. Ah, here we go. So if you do assemble your camera in an environment, in a humid environment, you actually do trap a lot of humidity inside your housing already. Most of the time, humid environments are also warmer environments. Now taking the camera down into colder water, or water that is colder than the surrounding temperature of the environment, what is going to happen is condensation will form inside your housing. Now that per se is not a big problem, but on some housings, that condensation will accumulate solely on the inside of your glass lens. And on other housings, that won't happen. For a long time, I couldn't explain to myself why one housing would fog up and the other one wouldn't. So I started looking into this issue and I came up with the following explanation. All housings are made out of more than just one material. Now this housing here, for example, is made out of polycarbonate, which is a fancy word basically for saying plastic. So the whole body is made out of plastic, and then the front element, the lens, this is made out of glass. Now glass and plastic, these two components, they have different characteristics when it comes to how they react to condensation and how they attract condensation if it happens inside your housing. Now on a polycarbonate housing or a plastic housing, your condensation will mostly happen on the glass lens on that housing. That differs if you, for example, switch to a aluminum or steel housing like this one over here. Steel will actually attract the humidity or the condensation more than the glass port or the glass lens of the housing. And thus the entire condensation, or most of it, will accumulate around the much larger surface area of the steel or aluminum body of that housing. So that doesn't mean that your aluminum housing is not prone to get condensation inside. It basically just means that the condensation will not be visible on the lens itself, but much rather will place itself around the camera inside the actual body of the housing. So what does that mean for us? Well, it basically means that if you're diving with a aluminum or steel housing, you don't really have to worry too much about the condensation, because even if it does happen, you won't really notice it on the lens. And if there's a little bit of condensation around inside the housing, that's not really going to do anything negative to you. But if you have a housing that is made out of plastic, polycarbonate, you should actually take some precautions when putting the camera inside the housing. Try to keep the temperature difference to a minimum between the environment where you put the camera inside the housing and the temperature of the water. If that's not possible, you can always use one of these, the little silicon gel bags that you can place inside your housing, and they are basically supposed to just suck up all the moisture, all the humidity, and that's what they do. So having one or two of these little bags inside your housing will actually help you get that moisture hopefully away from your lens and inside these little bags here, and obviously you'll have to replace them every now and then. You can buy these bags basically in every dive shop, or if you order something online, mostly in electronic gear that you buy, oftentimes you'll find some of these packages in there as well. So you can reuse them and put them inside your underwater housing if you desire so. Another tip I've got for you in terms of minimizing condensation inside your camera housing is to switch the camera off if you're not taking photos or filming. Because a camera that keeps running all the time will heat up and will therefore generate energy, warmth inside the housing, and can increase the condensation inside your housing as well. So turn it on when you take photos or film, turn it off if you're not taking any photos or not filming. And keep in mind that if you use the in-camera flash on your underwater camera, that will generate a lot of heat, a lot of energy, and thus obviously also increase the condensation, or can increase the condensation inside your housing. So try not to use it for extended periods of time. And as I said before, remember to switch your camera off if you're not using it underwater. All right, and that was it for today's video and our little journey and theory lesson into the field of fucked up cameras, or basically condensation building inside your underwater camera housing. Now, by no means this is meant to be a scientific explanation. I'm sure there's people out there that can explain you in much more detail why condensation actually happens, but this is what I've learned from my own experiences, and also how I've learned how I can deal with condensation inside my underwater camera housings. So if you've enjoyed this video, if you've got something out of it, or even if it was just entertaining, please do hit that like button. You know, it means a lot to all of us. And also consider subscribing to the channel so you're not missing out on any future videos like this that will be uploaded here very regularly. Thank you very much for your time, and I will see you next time through a not fucked up lens. Now, the problem is, or the issue here is that you have a color, it's not a color, it's a temperature change.